It's the law of the land that says peak-top properties can have at least £100,000 of Camden ratepayers' money. Owners of pre-1947 properties are allowed to extend them by 10% or be compensated by their council if it refuses them permission. Peaktop made a planning application to build 12 more flats on top of their 50-year-old block in Hampstead. Camden said no. They said the elderly residents in the block would be disturbed by the building work, the added height would obstruct light to existing flats, and development would increase the number of people living in an already crowded area. Residents were delighted.
We are enormously relieved. We're quite certain that it was the right planning decision, but we're very grateful that it was made.
But London MP John Wheeler says it's an outrage that compensation has to be paid to property companies.
As the law stands, the local authority has no alternative but to pay it. But I think it's a scandal that the ratepayers of a local authority and the residents should have to make this contribution to property speculators who are simply cashing in on an easy opportunity.
Camden Council say other property companies are applying for roof extensions in the hope of getting compensation when they're turned down. And they're getting their help from the firm who've just been offered £100,000 compensation here.
Yes, the Peaktop Properties, who were the first firm in the field, actually held a seminar for other property developers. And they put round a leaflet called Cascade of Gold. And I think that gives you an indication of the kind of people they are.
And Peaktop want even more. They say £100,000 isn't adequate compensation. Now an unlikely alliance of Labour's Camden and Conservative MP John Wheeler are asking the government to plug a loophole which is making sky-high profits for the property men at the expense of London's ratepayers. Simon Neave in Belsize Park for Thames News.